Howdy, it's me, Manic Mark, coming to you from the Bunker System. No, I'm non-Manic Mark. I'm the new non-Manic Mark, coming to you from the Bunker System, located underneath the Art Villa, found somewhere in the jungles of the Midwest. And today I'm coming to you with today's video. It features me, the new non-Manic Mark. I just don't have it in me anymore to be manic, so... coming up with, like, I thought maybe the high anxiety mark, but no, that's not the case either. So I don't even know what to call myself anymore. That's the thing. You know, people that tattoo the whites of their eyes red, in a couple of years they wake up like, oh no, I wanted the whites of my eyes to be blue, and now they're just permanently red. What am I going to do? Well, in my case, I can change my nickname to something else. I just don't know what it is yet. You're probably wondering who my new friend is. Well, it's the absurd prospector, the prospector of the absurd, prospectored, that doesn't sound right, of the absurd. He's prospecting, he's wearing his little prospector's hat. He's prospecting for absurdity right here in front of me. What could he find that would be absurd right here? I don't know. Okay, go on. How about this? How about the tortillas, Mexican flour products made out of silicone? That's pretty absurd. And then how about this bowl of rice and, whoa, you thought I was gonna, that's not real either. That's absurd. It's something else. Anyway, okay. I got some records today. Right here. This stack of records. I'm going to hold up. Share the records. Well, here's a photograph of the prospectored of the absurd. You can see him better here in this photograph. There you go. That's right. He's prospecting, always prospecting for something silly. Just silly. You know, here's the thing. Here's why I don't do anything that I did before. Because, here's the explanation of why I become who I am today, which is older, is that I was trying to make a life before. Now I'm just trying to live a life. And I tried to make a life by pointing out absurdities through absurdity. Which is my art. And then I realized that my art can't possibly capture life, the fullness of the absurdity of actual life, and what's the point, because you're surrounded by it. So I'm just joining it. I'm enjoying life, and I'm going to enjoy life rather than fight life, and with my art. And that's the long and short of it. That's why I have no ambition anymore. And why should I? Ambition is for young people. I'm not young anymore. And why don't you set a shining example of an old person who has ambition? Well, I have ambition. I go to the gym. But it's not like that. It's not the ambition to become something like an artist. Don't care anymore. That's right. Oh, no, it's just this or that. No, it's not. It's just a change in the way I manage what I do. That's all. I probably just cut this part out, but there you go. On to the records. It's a George Shearing quartet album that I don't have. This is kind of difficult, reaching around the prospectored of the absurd, but here you go. There's a George Shearing album. Capitol album. I don't have. Anyway, there you go. That'll be fun. I was lucky enough to find another Lorenzo Almeida album. I've been pronouncing it that way forever. I pronounced it that way at lunch the other day, and I was corrected. And I don't remember the correction. I don't remember, but it was completely different from the way I was pronouncing it. Charlie Bird, did I get that right? The other guy is Charlie Bird. Okay, Brazilian Soul, Lorenzo, whatever, and Charlie Bird. Oh my God. Anybody watch the Bengals football game last night? See, this is how normal I've become. I watched high school football, the All-Star game, And then I watched a college football game, then some game that's made history, just happened to be on. And then I watched our local team, the Bengals, play the Steelers, and then they were roundly chastised after the game was over, not only because they lost on a local level, but because of the brutality, the personal fouls, some pretty scary stuff if you're out there being smashed around like that. And so anyway, but then you got then people pointing fingers here and there. And frankly, I think after that game, I'm going to go back to I don't care about football for another couple of years. Anyway, okay, here we go. It's a sealed Peggy Lee. Peggy Lee, it's sealed. It's a specialty product, interestingly enough, from Capital, which means it was made for not for general distribution, right? Raindrops keep falling on her head, spinning wheels. She does some pop songs. Anyway, I don't know. Interesting. Later. And Judy Holliday. I think I may have this one, but I don't remember. But I like the cover. I picked it up again. Arrangements by Glenn Osser. Music direction by Buster Davis. A guitar album I picked up. It's 80s. I probably won't like it. All these 80s sort of jazz albums I pick up, I really don't like. But I picked it up anyway because there's always a chance I will like it. Buddy Miron is all steel guitar. I probably won't take it like this. It's sort of, well, let's see. There's, you know, it's all maybe kind of country. But Buddy Miron, I like. Okay, and speaking of him, here's another one. This is a much more fabulous cover on this guy, this album here. There's a song called Funky, and the theme from the Green Hornet, so that could be really good on that Buddy Merrill album, if I pronounce that right. Bill. Arranged and conducted by Dick Staybill. Bile. Stick Bile. Honk Honk Cha Cha. That could be good. Anyway, there you go. There's some good tunes on that one. It's the Meg Wells Quintet. Songs of Maids, Knaves, and Other Swingers. Alright. That could be fun. Here's another photograph on the back with her and the band right there. As I reach over the prospect turd of the absurd. Right there. Okay, and last but not least, I don't know. It's just a compilation album with a fun cheesecake cover. Cool sounds on the Hollywood label. There you go. Including Avalon and Opus Number 1. Okay. That was a great video. I really enjoyed making that. I had absolutely no energy when I came down here to make a video. And then I started painting on the Prospector of the Absurd, and I built up a little energy. But basically, it's one of those days where I feel like I'm getting a cold, but it's probably just because of the change in weather. It's snowing outside, it's ugly, it's been damp. I'm not sure, but I feel like crap, okay? But I've covered it up pretty good, I think. I think I covered it up pretty good. And here's one more. What am I going to do with this guy? Where am I going to put him? He's posed very strangely, because you can't... He's not creepy like the one I got upstairs. I can't put him upstairs. My wife will simply kill me if I do. If I put another creepy mannequin upstairs in a room in a corner or something, where when you walk by at night, it's like... You know, it just startles you for a second. More because he's wearing the absurd hat, I think, more than anything else. Rather than just being a fake person. Okay, there you go. Okay, great. Thanks for stopping by. Happy New Year and everything. All right. And now on to the musical sample. That's right.
I walk along the city streets you used to walk along with me. And every step I take recalls how much in love we used to be. Oh, how can I forget you when there is always something there to remind me? Always something there to remind me. I was born to love you, and I will never be free. You'll always be a part of me. Shadows fall, I pass the small cafe where we would dance at night. And I can't help recalling how it felt to kiss and hold you tight. Oh, how can I forget you when there is always something there to remind me? Always something. Find and miss the sweet and tender love we used to share. Just come back to the places where we used to go, and I'll be there. Oh, how can